Hi guys, welcome back. So a couple of months ago, I made a video on how to make a cupcake bag and it got so much positive feedback and so much love that I wanted to try to do something similar again. So in today's video, we're going to make an ice cream bag because where I am right now, it is so hot. So all I could think of was ice cream. So let's get started. So here are all the supplies you need to make your little ice cream bag. So you're going to need a base color for the cone. I'm going to be using this beige color. You can use any color that you want. All the yarns that I'm using today are Elise Cotton Gold because this is my absolute favorite yarn. You're also going to need three different colors. If you want to make three scoops or two scoops, depending on the number of scoops, you're going to need a different color for each of the ice cream flavors. Along with these, we're going to be using a crochet hook size 2.5 millimeters because that's what matches with my yarn. If your yarn is a little thicker, then go ahead and use a thicker hook. I also have some scrap red yarn. I'm going to use this to make a little cherry on top. You're going to need a pair of scissors, a yarn needle, and also a stitch marker. Now to start the project, we'll be starting from the cone. So the first step that you're going to do is create a magic ring. Hold the yarn between two fingers like this and create an X at the back of your fingers. Insert your hook into the bottom, pick up the top and twist, and then just pull up a loop. Now into this magic ring, you'll be placing four single crochets. Insert your hook, pull up the yarn, yarn over and pull through. That's 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now you're just going to tighten your magic ring to close it up. And for row number 2, we're going to place one single crochet in each of the stitches for 4 stitches for this row. So into that first stitch, we placed 1, into the one after that, 2, then 3 and 4. Now once you've completed this row, you can just grab your stitch marker and you're just going to place your stitch marker on the fourth stitch to keep track of your rows. Now for row number 3, we're going to place an increase all the way around or 2 single crochets in each stitch. So into the first one, we place 1 and 2, into the next one, 1 and 2. Into the one after that, 1 and 2, and into that last stitch again, 1 and 2, and this should bring your stitch count up from 4 to 8. Now for the next row, you're just going to place one single crochet all the way around for 8 stitches for this row. Now for the next row, you're going to place one single crochet followed by an increase 4 times all the way around for 12 stitches. So into that very first stitch right here, we're going to place 1. Into the one after that, we're going to place 1 and 2. Again into the next one, we place 1. Into the one after that, we place 1 and 2. And you're going to do this 4 times all the way around. Now for the next row, you're just going to place one single crochet all the way around for 12 stitches for this row. Now for the next row, we're going to place two single crochets followed by an increase. So one in the first stitch, one in the second stitch, followed by 2 in the next stitch. Again 1, 1, 1, 2. And you're going to do this 4 times all the way around for 16 stitches for this row. Now for the next row, you're just going to place one single crochet all the way around for 16 stitches for this row. Now for the next row, we're going to place 3 single crochets followed by an increase. So one in the first stitch, one in the second stitch, one in the third stitch, and in the fourth stitch, 1 and 2. You're going to do this 4 times all the way around for 20 stitches for this row. So now as you continue your rows, you can see that the little ice cream cone shape is coming up. What I suggest doing is just put one finger inside as you keep continuing. So that way it keeps shaping around your finger and you don't lose the shape. Now for the next row, we're just going to place one single crochet all the way around for 20 stitches for this row. Now for the next row, we're going to be placing 4 single crochets followed by an increase 4 times all the way around for 24 stitches for this row. Now for the next row, you'll place 1 single crochet all the way around for 24 stitches for this row. Now for the next row, we're going to place 5 single crochets followed by an increase 4 times all the way around for 28 stitches for this row. Now for the next row, you're just going to place 1 single crochet all the way around for 28 stitches for this row. Now for the next row, you're going to do 6 single crochets followed by an increase 4 times all the way around for 32 stitches for this row. Now for the next row, we're going to place 1 single crochet all the way around for 32 stitches for this row. Now for the next row, we're going to place 7 single crochets followed by an increase 4 times all the way around for 36 stitches for this row. Now for the next 2 rows, you're going to place 1 single crochet all the way around for 36 stitches per row. So now at this point, we're going to switch colors and we're going into the first color of the ice cream. I'm going to use this mint green. So to join the new color, I'm just going to attach it to the loop that I have right here. Tighten the loop. Pull this through as well. And then just snip off this yarn. Now we're going to do 1 row of single crochets all the way around. So now in the new color, you're just going to do 1 row of single crochets until you have 36 stitches for this row. Now for the next row, we're going to start with a chain of 2, so chain 2. Now you're going to skip the next stitch. Into the stitch after that, you're going to place a single crochet, skip the stitch after that, and then place 4 double crochets. Yarn over, insert your hook, pull up a loop. You have 3 loops on the hook. Yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Again, skip a stitch, into the stitch after that a single, skip a stitch, into the next one, 4 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4. Skip the next one, single, skip the next one, 4 double. And you're going to do this all the way around. Once you're done with these scallops, you're just going to slip stitch onto that second chain of the initial chain 2. And if you see, this gives it a little scalloped border. So now we're actually going to start working on the inside. So to work on the inside, we're first going to pull up this loop a little bit. Turn our work around and go into the stitch right below this, which is this one. Put the loop over the hook. Just tighten it a little bit. So like this. And you're just going to pull this through. So now you reach the inside and we're going to continue working on the inside. So first we're going to chain 2, 1 and 2, and then we're going to place 1 double crochet all the way around. So to do a double crochet, you have to be a little careful over here because you're supposed to go on the inside of the stitches. So if you can see, there's a stitch right here. I'm going to go into that. We have 3 on the hook, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2, into the next one. Another one, into the one after that, another one, and you're going to do this till you have 36 stitches all the way around. So in this row, you're going to have to wing it a little bit. You won't exactly be able to find the stitches, but make sure that at the end of this row, you have 36 double crochets. Now that I've completed the 36 double crochets, I'm just going to slip stitch onto the second chain of the initial chain 2. So now if you see, the little scallops have come down and it gives a nice border before we start our first ice cream layer. So now to start the next row, we're going to chain two again. So one and two, and this won't be counted as a double crochet. Now you're going to place eight double crochets followed by an increase. So remember, now you're placing double crochets. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8 double crochets followed by a double crochet increase. So 1 and 2 in the same stitch. You're going to do this 4 times all the way around for 40 stitches for this row. Now once you're done with this row, we're again going to slip stitch onto the top of the chain 2. So on the second chain of the chain 2, and I just want to show you what the shape looks like. So you can just pull these out a little bit, and that's what it looks like. So now this is the pattern that you're going to follow for the next 4 rows. You're going to start with a chain 2 and then place 1 double crochet all the way around for 40 stitches for each of the rows. At the end of the row, make sure that you slip stitch into the top of the chain 2 or the second chain. So complete your 4 rows and then meet me back here again. So now I've completed the last of the 4 rows and I've slip stitched onto the chain 2. Now we're going to switch colors to the pink. So now in order to switch colors, we're just going to put the new color in front of the old one and just pull it through. Now you're just going to tighten both strings and then cut off the mint green. Now we're going to make the scallop once again. So to make the scallop, you're going to start with a chain of 2, 1 and 2. Skip the next stitch into the stitch after that, place a single. Skip the next stitch into the one after that, 4 doubles. Skip the next one into the next one, a single. Skip the next one into the next one, 4 doubles. And you're going to continue this all the way around. So now I'm done with this row of scallops and I'm just going to slip stitch onto the top of the first chain 2. Now we're going to do the same thing. Pull up the string, go into the stitches on the bottom, pick up this string, pull it through, and then now start working on the inside again. So we're going to start with a chain 2 and then place 1 double crochet all the way around until we have 40 stitches for this row. Once you're done with that, for the next 4 rows, you're just going to chain 2 and then place 1 double crochet all the way around for 40 stitches. At the end of each row, don't forget to slip stitch onto the first chain of the chain 2. So complete these 5 rows, this row plus 4 more rows, and then I'll show you how to proceed. So now that we're done with this row, we're going to attach one more color and do this one last time. So I'm going to attach my yellow. I've already snipped off my pink yarn. Just going to tighten it a little bit. We're going to do a row of scallops. So chain 2, skip the next stitch into the one after that, place a single, skip the one after that and place 4 double crochets, and do this all the way around until you reach the other side. So now once you're done, we're going to go ahead and do our rows of double crochet like we've been doing before. But this time, instead of doing 5 rows, we're only going to be doing 3. So again, insert your hook into the bottom. You can pick up this loop that you just pulled and tighten it. Pull it through, chain 2, turn your work around, and then you can start placing double crochets on the inside. So since we've not done any increases in the last couple of rows, this is also going to be 40 double crochets. So you're going to place 40 double crochets on the inside, then slip stitch to the second chain of this chain 2, chain 2 again a row of double crochets, again slip stitch, and you're going to do that one more time, and then you'll be done with this part of your ice cream cone. So now that I'm done with the top layer, we're going to make one more layer just for the drawstring to go around. So you're going to start with a chain two. We're going to skip the next two stitches and place a single crochet in the next two stitches. Again, chain two, skip two, and then two single crochets. Once again, chain two, skip two, followed by two single crochets. So this is what it should look like, and we're going to put the drawstring through this gap which comes in the middle. So now I'm right at the end. I've done my last chain two, and I'm going to go to the first chain two that I made and just slip stitch to the top. So that completes this. Now I'm going to leave a tail just for sewing in, and then snip this off. So this finishes the basic structure of your ice cream cone. Now we have a couple of steps left. We're going to make a little drawstring that's going to go into this, and we're going to work on a cherry. Now let's work on the drawstring. You're just going to make a slip knot like this, insert your hook and tighten it, and you're going to chain 65. Now once you're done with your chains, you can just snip the yarn off and pull it through, and that completes the little drawstring. So now I've just threaded on my drawstring, and I'm just going to go in and out of these spaces and just put my drawstring through. You can do this without the needle also. I just find that it's much easier when I do it with the needle. Once you're done, you can just adjust both sides to be equal. So when you open it, it looks like this, and when you close it up, it looks like a little ice cream. Now we're going to add a cherry right on top. Now to do the cherry, I'm going to use some scrap red yarn that I have. We're going to start with a magic ring again, but this time into the magic ring we're going to place 6 single crochets. So there I have my magic ring. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and now you're just going to tug to close up your magic ring. For row number 2, we're going to place an increase all the way around, or 2 single crochets in every stitch, for a total of 12 stitches for this row. Now once you're done with the increases all the way around, for the next row we're going to place 1 single crochet followed by an increase 6 times all the way around for 18 stitches for this row. Now for the next 2 rows, you're just going to place 1 single crochet all the way around for 18 stitches per row. Now for the next row, you're going to place 1 single crochet followed by a decrease for a total of 12 stitches. Now for the last row, you can decrease all the way around and then fasten off. Now once you're done, you can just leave a tail, snip the yarn off, pull it through, and then just shape it a little bit. So now you can hide this tail inside this little cherry. So now we're going to do the very last step. The first thing you're going to do is make sure that your strings are cut of the same length on both sides, and then just thread it on to your yarn needle like this. Now you're going to take this, put it through the cherry, and you're going to have to poke it a little bit tightly to make sure it goes on the inside. Now you can just adjust it, and you have a little cap that goes right on top. So now if you open it up, this is what it looks like, and if you close it, this is what it looks like. Now what I hope you enjoyed this video. If you liked the video, please comment down below and let me know what you want to see next. Like the video, share it with all your friends, and subscribe to my channel. Until next time, bye-bye.